Good evening. New at 11, a local business is turning down some of its customers. Working for you, RTV6 is learning how a self-imposed rule could keep young teens from developing bad habits. Our Stephanie Wade shows you how a local shop is hoping to fight back against underage vaping.
This sign might cause you to pause as you're walking into the Fog Foundry Vape Lounge. It reads, "Must be 19 to enter." Well, if you vape, you know the legal age to buy e-cigarettes is 18. But since the recent rise in underage teen vaping, one local shop owner is out to change that, at least at his shops.
We've been in this industry for some long time, and we know that there are 18-year-olds that do step into our shop that purchase product to make a profit.
Chad Myers is concerned about others in his industry making a profit off of kids who are still in high school, as Juuls, or e-cigarette devices that mimic the look of USB flash drives, have become extremely popular amongst young teens.
The 18-year-olds are definitely more of a connection, because if you look, how many 18-year-olds do you know that are seniors in high school? There's several. There's very few 19-year-olds that are in high school.
For that reason, Myers' three stores located in Lafayette, Kokomo, and Frankfort have stopped selling to 18-year-olds and instead have risen their age minimum to 19. He says it's to make sure adolescents don't kickstart a habit they never had. Vaping products serve as an alternative to cigarette smoking. They don't have tobacco, but they do contain nicotine.
Why start when they're in middle school, high school, and picking up this nicotine habit when they can live a healthier lifestyle and not have that habit at all?
Now, they don't even sell Juul products here because they know how popular they are with the younger high school students. A Juul spokesperson also tells me they don't want young teens using them either, and they strongly support raising the minimum age to purchase these products to 21.
One Juul pod contains as much nicotine as one pack of cigarettes, and that's a lot of nicotine, especially for an adolescent brain, and that's where our biggest concern is.
A tobacco specialist with IU Health says there was a 78% increase from 2017 to 2018 in high school students using e-cigarettes. While it's too early to say what long-term effects using nicotine may have, what she can say in the meantime:
it can cause things like learning difficulties, concentration problems, mood disorders, and things like that.
And that's why she recommends delaying the use of vape products as much as possible. Working for you in Lafayette, Stephanie Wade, RTV6.
An interesting story. Thank you, Steph. And last month, a bill that would raise the age to buy e-cigarettes to 21 nationwide passed out of committee. The bill is sponsored by Indiana Senator Todd Young. It would also raise the age for purchasing tobacco products to 21.